वेलकम बैक ऑल ऑफ यू टू आवर ऑनलाइन प्लेटफॉर्म दैट एवर स्कूल्स यूट्यूब चैनल। सो अगेन वी आर रेडी विद टुडेज वीडियो। दिस वीडियो इज फॉर क्लास सिक्स एंड द सब्जेक्ट इज मैथ्स एंड वी आर कंटिन्यूइंग द सेम चैप्टर दैट इज चैप्टर नंबर 8 एंड द नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर इज डेसिमल्स। एज यस्टरडे ओनली वी हैव स्टार्टेड दिस चैप्टर एंड वी स्टार्टेड द एक्सरसाइज 8.1 एंड वी हैव कंप्लीटेड अप टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 3। सो टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट विद क्वेश्चन नंबर 4। इन क्वेश्चन नंबर 4 वी आर सपोज टू राइट the following as decimals. So first one, a part is 5/10, b part is 3/7/10, and c part is 200 + 60 + 5 + 1/10. Then D part, now the D part is 70 + 8/10, and then E part is 88/10. 88/10. Then F part is 4/2/10. 4/2/10. Then G part 3/2. G part is 3/2, and then H 2/5, then I part is there, then 12/5, afterwards J part is there, J part is 3/5, and afterwards K part is there, in K part that is 4/1/2, 4/1/2. So now in the first one, that 5/10, so first of all we will put the decimal. Before decimal there will be ones place, means before means on the left hand side. On the right hand side there will be tenth, hundredth and thousandth. So here no ones is there, so in place of ones it is zero. How many tenths are there? 5. So that is 5. Again we will put the decimal here. How many ones are there? 3. 3 will be on the left hand side of the decimal. How many tenths are there? That is 7. 7 tenths. So here how many hundreds? First of all we will put the decimal. How many hundreds are there? 200. How many tenths? 6. How many ones? 5. Then tenths, 1 tenth is there. Here how many hundreds are there? 0. Tenths, 7. Ones, there is no ones. Then how many tenths are there? 8. So 70.8 is the answer. Now here again no ones are there, but 88 tenths are there. So what we will do in such type of questions, first of all we will convert that improper fraction into mixed fraction, and that will become 8 and 8/10, and then here this is the whole part, and whole part is ones, and how many tenths are there? 8. Similarly here how many ones are there? Ones are the whole part, that is 4, and tenths 2. In such type of questions we cannot assess how many tens are there. So what we will do? We have to make here 10. So to make 10, we have to multiply by 5. If we multiply by 5 in the denominator, we have to multiply by 5 in the numerator as well. We will get 5 3 is 15 upon 5 2 is 10. Then we will convert that into mixed fraction. It will become 1 and 5 upon 10. Now this is the whole part, means ones and now 5 upon 10, 5 is the tens. Now here again, that is not in the form where we are having denominator 10, so we will make 10 by multiplying it 2. Here also we have to multiply by 2, so it will become 4 upon 10, means there is no ones. So in the ones place we will put 0, in the tens place we will put 4. Here again we have to make 10, so we will multiply by 2. Here we have to multiply by 2 and we will get 24 upon 10. Now we are supposed to convert into mixed fraction, 2 and 4 by 10. Now the whole part is the ones, means 2, and then tens, that is 4. Now here again that 10 is not there, so for 10 we can multiply here by 2 and we can multiply here by 2, and this will become 3, and we are multiplying the fraction part only. 3 2 is 6 and 5 2 is 10. Like this. Now what we will do, first of all we will convert that into the improper fraction, because we have to multiply. 5 3 is 15, 15 plus 3 18 upon 5. Now we have to multiply by 2 here, multiply by 2 here, so it will become 36 upon 10. Now we can write in the mixed fraction 3 and 6 by 10, so it will become, now the whole part is the ones and then tens. Now here again, so what we will do, 4 2 is 8 plus 1 9 by 2, and now we have to multiply by 5 to make it 10. So we have to multiply the numerator as well by 5, so it will become 45 upon 10. Now we have to convert into mixed fraction, that will become 4 and 5 upon 10. Now the whole part is the ones, and then how many tens are there? 5. So like this we are supposed to proceed this question. I hope that you have understood. Now in question number 5, as I am rubbing the board, at the same time you can read the question. As I told you previously that you should have your textbooks with you while watching the videos. So now question number 5 is there. So write the following decimals as fraction, reduce the fractions to a lowest form. So A part 0.6, B part is 2.5, C part is 1.0, and D part is 3.8, E part is there 13.7, and at last the F part is there. In F part, that is 21.2, and one more part is there, that is Z part, that is 6.4. Now this is the converse of the previous question. In the previous question, the fractional form was given. We are supposed to convert into decimal form. Here, the decimal form is given. We have to convert into the fraction form. So, what we will do? We will write the same thing without decimal. Now, as here 0.6, so we have written 6, 2.5, 25, 1.0, 10, 3.8, 38, 13.7, 137, 21.2, 212, and 6.4, that is 64. And the denominator will be 1 in each of the cases. Now, after putting 1, we have to see how many digits are there after the decimal. How many digits are there? 1. So we will put 10. Here, how many digits? 1. Here, 1. Here, 1. Here again, 1. Here again, 1. Here again, 1. So how many digits are there after a decimal? We will put that times 0. So here, that 6 and 10 comes in the table of 2. So 2, 3 is a 6. 2 5 is a 10, so the answer is 3 upon 5. Here 25 and 10 comes in the table of 5, 5 5 is a, and 5 2 is a, so answer will be 5 upon 2. Here 10 comes in the table of 1 upon 1, so the answer will be 1 upon 1. Here 38 and 10 comes in the table of 2, 19, and here 5, so 19 upon 5, and afterwards, so this is already in the lowest form. Here we can cut by 2, 106, and 5, so 106 upon 5. Here again we can cut by 2, 32 upon 5, 32 upon 5. So like this we are supposed to proceed the questions given in this chapter. Now, again, what we have done today, you have to repeat first of all, then you have to try the upcoming questions. And if you are facing some problem or if you are having any doubt, then you can message us or you can even call us. We will try to rectify your doubt so that you can easily proceed the questions given in the textbook. Thank you. Thank you very much.